Hello everyone. Today we continue with Computer System Architecture course, Chapter 5, Basic Computer Organization and Design. In the previous videos, we discussed the first two sections, instruction codes and computer registers. Today our topic is computer instructions. According to the stored program concept, both instructions and data are stored in memory. In the basic computer, we have 4,096 locations, each of size 16 bits. To execute an instruction, we should fetch it from memory, and usually we store it in a register called instruction register, also of size 16 bits, then decode it, then execute it. And we will come to the instruction cycle, fetch, decode, execute later on this chapter. The important thing here is that the instruction size is 16 bits. We already know that the instruction in the basic computer, as well as in any general purpose computer, consists of two main parts, operation code and the address part. And one bit from the operation code is allocated for the I bit, which is the addressing mode bit, to distinguish between the direct and indirect addressing modes. The operation code field specifies the instruction to be executed: add, increment, decrement, clear, load, store, etc. In the address field, we have the address of operand. Again here, the I bit, operation code, and the address. Since we have 4,096 locations in memory, we need 12 bits to address any location. So 12 bits from the total 16 bits are assigned for the address. We have remaining here 4 bits. 1 bit is assigned for the addressing mode, I, and the 3 bits remaining for the operation code, 12 to 14. And tier 15. According to this format, we have three types of instruction. First, memory reference instructions, register reference instructions, and input output instructions. In memory reference instructions, the operation code ranges from 000 to 110. If the mode bit is 0, then we have direct addressing, I0, direct addressing, and on I1, we have indirect addressing. Now, regarding register reference instructions and input-output instructions, in both cases, in the operation code field, we have 111. Since in these instructions, we do not use memory, no need to reference memory, then we can use the I bit and the address field for other purposes. If the I field is 0, then we have register reference instruction. And if the I bit is 1, then we have IO instruction. The remaining parts of the instruction or the address field part can be used as an operation code for the instruction. Note that the first hexadecimal digit in all register reference instructions is 7, and the first hexadecimal digit in all input-output instructions is F. I will repeat again the instruction code formats. In register reference instructions, we have here 111, and the mode bit can be used to distinguish between a register reference instruction and input-output instruction. If this bit is 0, then we have register reference instruction, and if this bit is 1, we have input-output instruction. They have the same value in the operation code field, 111. The remaining part of the instruction can be used as a code for the register operation or as a code for the IO operation. If the operation code field is not 111, then we have memory reference instruction. In this case, the operation code ranges from 000 through 110. And here there is a function for the IBIT. If the IBIT 0, then we have direct address sync, which means that the address field contains the address of the operand. However, if the IBIT is 1, we have indirect address sync, which means that the address field contains the address of memory location that contains or stores the address of the operand. You can note that the first hexadecimal digit in any register reference instruction is 7. Here it is. And we have the remaining 3 hexadecimal digits for the register operation. And the first hexadecimal digit of any IO instruction is F. And the remaining 3 hexadecimal digits are used for the IO operation. However, in memory reference instructions, here we have the first hexadecimal digit can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E. So the 7 and F are not included. And here we have 3 X's in all cases. And these hexadecimal digits are the address of the operand. In this case, since we have direct address sync, or the address of memory location that contains the address of the operand, since here we have indirect address sync. Here, indirect address sync. Here we have direct address sync. If you write the hexadecimal digit 0 through 6, 0000, 0001, etc., 0110. The first bit in all cases is 0. And if you write here the first hexadecimal digit, which is 1000, 1001 through 1110, the first bit in all these cases is 1, which means that we have indirect address sync. So in hexadecimal, for register reference instruction, we have the operation code field 7, and the remaining bits are used for register operation. In IO instruction, we have F, and the remaining are used for IO operation. And for memory reference instruction, the code is one of these for direct addressing mode or one of these combinations for indirect addressing. a quick revision. If the instruction is register reference instruction or input output instruction, then the operation code is 111, these 3 bits. Since in these two cases, we do not need to access memory, then this part is used for the operation code for the instruction. To distinguish register reference instructions from IO instruction, the I bit is used. If the I bit is 0, then the instruction is register reference instruction. And if the I bit is 1, then the instruction is input output instruction. Now, if the operation code is not, if the operation code is not 111, then we have memory reference instruction. In memory reference instruction, both the I field and the address field have their functions. If the I bit is 0, then we have direct addressing, and if I is 1, we have indirect addressing. In both cases, the address field is required. If the addressing mode is direct, then the address field contains the address of the operand, here, the address of the operand. And if the addressing mode is indirect, then the address field contains the address of address, or it contains the address of memory location that contains the address of operand. The size of the operation code field is 3 bits. And using 3 bits, we can encode 8 operations only. However, in the basic computer, we have 25 different operations or instructions. This is because we use the address field in both register reference instructions and input output instructions for the operation code. These are the memory reference instructions in the basic computer. And add, load, store, branch unconditionally, a branch and save return address, increment and skip if 0. Here we have I0, meaning direct mode, and I1, indirect mode. So the operation code field for the AND operation, for example, is 0 or 8, meaning we have 0, 0, 0. If the I bit is 0, then we have 4 zeros, and the remaining bits are used for the address part, and the code here is 0. However, if we have here 1 with the 3 zeros, then the first 6 decimal digit is 8, and the remaining bits are used for the address field, here 8. And for the add, for example, add, the operation code field is 001, these 3 bits. If the I bit is 0, direct addressing, then we have 1 here, and the remaining bits are used for the address. And if the addressing mode is indirect, we'll have 1001, and this is 9. So this is add indirect. And in the same manner, this is the load instruction, indirect mode, store, branch unconditionally, branch and save return address, increment and skip if 0. Regarding the description, the AND operation is used to AND the contents of the address memory location with the contents of the accumulator. After reading the instruction, we decode it. The operation code is AND. Now we have to bring the operand from memory. If the addressing mode is direct, then the address field is used to retrieve the memory location, which stores the operand. After reading the operand, It is ANDed with the contents of the accumulator, and the result is stored in the accumulator. And if the addressing mode is indirect, then we have to access memory twice to retrieve the operand, and again we AND it with the accumulator, and the result is stored in the accumulator. Add is used to add memory location to accumulator. Load is used to load the contents of memory location and store it into the accumulator. And store is used to store the contents of the accumulator into the memory location whose address is specified in the instruction. Branch unconditionally is like go to statement. It is used to branch or jump to another area in memory. Usually the instructions are executed one after another. So the branch unconditionally is a transfer of control statement. Branch and save retain address is similar to the go sub or branch to a subroutine. The difference between the branch unconditionally and the branch and save retain address is that in the branch unconditionally to location, for example, 155, we branch to the instruction at location 155 and continue. While in the branch and save retain address to location, for example, 155, the retain address here is saved. And after that, we branch to location 155. Here we have subroutine usually. At the end of the subroutine, we have RET statement, and it retains control back to the statement that follows the branch and save retain address. And we will come to this later in this chapter. Increment and skip of zero increments the contents of the accumulator, and if the result is zero, we skip the next instruction. The second set of instructions in the basic computer are register reference instruction. As you see here, the operation code field for all these instructions is 7. So here we have 7. And the remaining 12 bits, or the address field here, is used as an operation code for the instruction. The mode bit is 0 since 7 in hexadecimal is 0111 in binary. And here the mode bit is used to distinguish between the register reference instructions and the IO instructions. In IO instructions, we have 1111. These bits are the same in both the register reference instructions and in input-output instructions. The instructions are clear accumulator. The operation code is 800. Clear a flip-flop 400, complement accumulator, complement a flip-flop, circulate right accumulator and a flip-flop, circulate left accumulator and a flip-flop, increment accumulator, skip next instruction if accumulator is positive, skip next instruction if accumulator is negative, skip next instruction if accumulator is zero, skip next instruction if E flip-flop is zero. And the last instruction is the halt instruction. So in total, we have 12 register reference instructions. And the third group of instructions in the basic computer is input, output, and interrupt instructions. Here, the operation code field is F, all ones. So the mode bit here is 1, to distinguish input-output instruction from register reference instructions. Register reference instructions, I/O and interrupt instructions. And again here, as in register reference instructions, the remaining 12 bits or the address field is used as an operation code for the instruction. The input instruction with code 800 inputs a character from an input device and transfer it to accumulator. The input character here is stored in the least significant bit of the accumulator. Output instruction with code 400 is used to output character from accumulator to the output device. Skip on input flag with operation code 200 skips the next instruction if the input flag is 1. Skip on output flag with code 100 skips the next instruction if the output flag is 1. Interrupt on with code 080 in hexadecimal and interrupt off instruction with code 040 in hexadecimal. At the end of this chapter, we'll come to these instructions in more detail. Here we have the complete set of instructions in the basic computer. The total number of instructions is 25. Although commercial computers have more instructions, but by using a limited number of instructions, it's possible to show the detailed design of the computer. Next, about instruction set completeness. A computer should have a set of instructions so that the user can construct machine language programs to evaluate any function that is known to be computable. The set of instructions are said to be complete if the computer includes a sufficient number of instructions in each of the following categories: arithmetic, logical and shift instructions, instructions for moving information to and from memory and processor registers, program control instructions together with instructions that check status conditions, and input and output instructions. Arithmetic, logic, and shift instructions provide computational capabilities for processing the data. We need the second set because information is stored in RAM, but processing is performed in CPU. Therefore, these instructions are used to move information from RAM to the CPU and store results back into RAM. Regarding the third group, decision-making capabilities are an important aspect of digital computers. In addition, program control instructions, such as branch instructions, are used to change the sequence in which the program is executed. I/O instructions are needed for communication between the computer and the user. First, regarding the arithmetic, logic, and shift instructions. In the basic computer, we have the add, complement, accumulator, increment, circulate left, and circulate right. Add is used to add two numbers, and for subtraction, for example, A minus B, we use the add with the 2's complement of B. So we can complement B, increment its value, and then add it to A, and this is equivalent to A minus B. Multiplication and division can be performed using addition, subtraction, and shifting. Regarding the logic operations, we have the AND instruction, complement accumulator, and clear accumulator. and complement provide NAND operation. And as you know, NAND is a universal operation. We can express any Boolean function using NAND operation only. And even we can implement any logic circuit using NAND gates only. Regarding instructions for moving information to and from memory and the processor registers, we have here two instructions. The load that moves the contents of the specified memory location into the accumulator, and the store that stores the contents of the accumulator into the specified memory location. The third group is program control instruction, together with the instructions that check status conditions. Here we have a branch and conditionally, a branch and save return address, increment and skip if zero. In addition to four skip instructions, skip on positive accumulator, skip on negative accumulator, skip on zero accumulator, and skip on zero if flip-flop. These four skip instructions provide capabilities for program control and checking of status conditions. And in the last group, input and output instructions, we have two instructions, input and output. And in addition to these instructions, we have skip on input flag, skip on output flag, interrupt on, interrupt off instructions. A complete list of instructions used on commercial computers are discussed on chapter 8. But in this chapter and in the following chapters, we are going to use only these instructions. And as I mentioned, it's easier to show the detailed design of the computer using a limited number of instructions. Today, I'll stop here. In the next video, we are going to discuss timing and control. For today, that's all. Thank you.